sail for the sky. Meet behind Mars. We will hold each other as we sail for the stars, making star love in the night. Across the universe, we will sail for the sky. Meet behind Mars. We will hold each other as we sail for the stars. On our cosmic flame, we will kiss in Saturn's wings. Make the Milky Way blush to see the sign. Making stars. We used to be real close. Said he couldn't go on the American way. Closed the shop, sold the house, bought a ticket for the West Coast. Now it gives him a standard routine in LA. I don't need you to worry about me, 'cause I'm alright. I don't need you to tell me it's time to go home. You say anymore, this is my life. Go ahead with your own life, leave me alone. 'Cause this is my kind of life, my kind of life. Yes, and I like it. This is my kind of life, my kind of life. Yes, and I like it. This is my kind of life, yeah. And I wouldn't have it anyway, other than sitting down. I never said I was the victim of circumstance. Don't get me wrong, I still belong. You can change your mind, but not on my time. They will tell you you can't sleep alone in a strange place. Then they tell you you can't sleep with somebody else. Ah, but sooner or later you sleep in your own space. Either way, it's
okay, you wake up with yourself. This is my kind of life, my kind of life, yes, and I like it. This is my kind of life, my kind of life, yes, and I like it. This is my kind of life, yeah, and I would have it anyway, other than sitting down somewhere playing away my days. This is my kind of life, yeah, my kind of life, yeah. Yes, and I like it.
For a pot of tea. I thought you were parked here for the rest of the day. Well, I'm afraid there'll be an extra charge for the use of the space after normal time allowed.
Oh, you just couldn't overlook it this time, could you? I mean, I didn't realise how long I'd been here.
Tell that to the cashier, dear.
Now, I'd like to introduce a lady who I've had the great pleasure of seeing in concert, a singer-songwriter and a brilliant new talent. Ladies and gentlemen, Judy Zook.
Thank you.
Doctor. Ah, it's Mrs. Bradshaw here. Well, do you remember you told me to take the 300 extra concentrated double-strength king-sized halibut orange tablets? Yeah, and the half litre of cod liver oil? Yeah. Well, I think it's having side effects. There's no end, no front and back, my love won't bend. I'm in the middle, lost in a spin, loving you. My love has no bottom, my love has no top. My love won't rise and my love won't drop. I'm in the middle, and I can't stop loving you. That makes my love wider than wide. I'm in the middle, and I can't hide loving you. And you don't know, you don't know, you don't know, you don't know how bad I am. And you don't know, you don't know, you don't know, you don't know. I were a poet, so I could express what I'd like to say. Yeah, yeah. And I wish I were an artist, so I could paint a picture of how I feel, of how I feel today. Yeah, yeah. My love has no walls on either side. That makes my love wider than wide. I'm in the middle, and I can't hide loving you. The most talked about radio show was The Goon Show, and later on it was Beyond Our Ken. Today, it's the news headlines. Will you please welcome the star of that show, Roy Hood?
Oh, I'm not so loud of that. Huh? Look at that. How many kids you got, Marty?
Two.
Two? Blimey, they say lightning never strikes in the same place twice. Look at that.
Yeah, I must say, you look rather fantastic. Tell me, what's in the news today, then?
Well, recently, as far as the news headlines is concerned, of course, the royal family are in the news. They're always in the news, aren't they?
Yes.
And how delighted we all are, aren't we, that Prince Charles has finally decided to tie the knot. He's going to rope himself into the saddle next time he goes racing. Now, you've got to pay attention, because there's a lot of quick stuff coming here, I tell you, right? They've just discovered, you know, how why he keeps coming out the saddle, you know.
Oh, yeah, why is that?
Well, it's every time he picks up speed, you see, the wind catches his ears and lifts him out the saddle.
Do you ever get, you know, you get a lot of your stuff from the sports pages, because I listen to the
Hoodlums. Well, now, the sports, of course, is always good for a laugh. Mind you, that lot are not much of a laugh over there in the West Indies, are they?
No.
They tell me Ian Botham now has put the entire England cricket team on a diet of curry only. Curry for breakfast, curry for tea and curry for supper. It's the only way they can get the runs. If you like, if you like. Everyone.
I'll tell you what, my favourite sports story was when the one about when Ray Reardon was photographed with a topless model. Mm. And he said he enjoyed it, especially when he choked the wrong tip.
Yeah. I'll tell you my favourite sports joke of the lot, shall I? Now, this was topical just a few years ago when Peter Benetti, you remember Peter Benetti the cat, was playing for Chelsea, you see? So there's a big fire in a block of flats in Chelsea, and there's an Italian lady on an 8th-floor flat. And she's got a baby in her arms, and the flat's on fire, and the firemen are down below, and they said, he said, come on, throw the baby down, love. She said, no, no, I'm not to throw the baby down.
Yeah, shut up, you bitch.
She said, I don't trust you English firemen. She said, you want to catch the baby, it's no good. They said, look, we've got a blanket here, we'll catch it in it. He said, no, don't trust you.
She said, I know trust... you lot, you'll go, holy! Yeah.
English firemen. Wrong joke. Anyway... And she said, right. She said, look, he said, the only person I trust to catch my baby, the man with the safest hands in Chelsea, Peter Bonetti, the cat who plays in the goal for Chelsea. So she said, I'm not throwing the baby down. They said, look, Friday, she said, I'm not throwing the baby down. They should get Peter Bonetti to catch it. So I go around to Chelsea football ground, see, it's telling, explain it to Bonetti. Round he comes. He says, right, I'm here, love. She says, oh, Peter Bonetti, the cat, thank goodness you're here. No, throw the baby down. He said, okay, let me have it. So she threw the baby down. He went, got it. Boom, boom, boom.
Tell you what, you must be the only fella in Britain who gets some fun out of the politicians.
Oh, we've stopped laughing now, though, haven't we, eh?
Oh, yeah, well...
With the new governor, eh? Margaret Thatcher, the Ayatollah of Chelsea. Yeah.
The woman who's done more for the economy than Herod did for mother care. It's all right, I'll tell you something else. But the other lot are no better.
They're no better. I mean, who's in charge of that? Like Michael Foot?
I don't know.
Michael Foot, the Wurzel Gummidge of Westminster?
Do you know, he took his suit to be cleaned last week and they refused it.
She's a godsend. Come up here, mate. You're doing better than we are. Now, I tell you what worries me about the politicians. I mean, we don't know who's on our side anymore. All this spy business, I've never heard anything like it, have you? Because they say the Russians have always had the best secret service in the world, and now they have, haven't they? Yeah. They've got it, ours.
Oh, right. I know that MI5 don't have a tea lady and a trolley anymore. They have a Cossack and a bottle of vodka. Mm-hmm.
But I don't think Britain belongs to the British anymore, you see. I mean, you walk around London now, am I right, girls? You can't ever find a Londoner, can you? No, of course you can't. I mean, look at Knightsbridge, full of Arabs there, isn't it?
Right.
I went to Knightsbridge last week, I had to leave my shoes in Fulham.
I heard about an Arab who got stopped by the police coming out of Harrods.
Yeah?
He'd come out and not paid for it. Actually, I heard a nice story the other day about the Israeli-Arab war. Apparently, when there was a lull in the fighting, this Israeli chap decided to take his dog for a walk in the desert. Now, this dog, you'd never seen anything like this dog. Little short bow legs, big belly that sort of dangled in the sand, short pushed-up nose, horrible thing, it was horrible. Anyway, he's taking it for a walk in the desert, when coming towards him is this Arab guy with the biggest...
What is it? Really?
Yeah. Now, wait for it. The biggest Irish wolfhound you've ever seen, all teeth and hair it is. This great big... And he's walking... And he said to him, he said, here, just a minute. He says, you're an Israeli, aren't you? He said, I'm going to kill you. He said, now, hold on a minute. Yeah, relax, take it easy. He said, I've got a much better idea. He said, why don't we let the dogs fight? And whoever's dogs wins, we'll take the other one prisoner. He said, done. Right, after three, one, two, three, let the dogs off the lead. And this Israeli dog leapt 4 foot in the air and gumped, swallowed this Irish wolfhound in one step like that. Bam, gone. This Arab said, by heck, he said, I mean, fair dues, I'll be your prisoner. He said, but I've never seen anything like that. He said, flipping heck. He said, what kind of dog is that? He said, well, I don't know what you call it now, but before it had a nose job, it were a crocodile. Two letters, I think it's two, about me dresses. You know?
About your dresses?
Yeah.
Some what about
said them? Well, they said they're a bit revealing. But about 1910, 1920, Maury Lloyd did a little song after remarks about her dresses, and the song was, do you think my dress is a little bit, just a little bit, not too much of it? If it shows my figure just a little bit, that's the little bit the boys admire. Do you remember that?
Well, of course, you know, I mean, and And really, for well over 100 years, topical political stuff's always been very popular in the music hall. Now, about the 1870s, there was a very famous performer called the Great MacDermot, he called himself.
Okay.
Oh, and he used to do songs all about the politicians and their troubles. Yeah. And this is a song, it's over, well over 100 years old, and it was a political song. Yeah. And the subjects in the song were Disraeli and Gladstone.
Yeah.
But the song still works today. All you've got to do is change the two names, as you can imagine. Yeah. But to do it properly, if you want, shall I do it for you?
Yeah, yeah.
Because what we've got to do, we've got to use the audience in this, you see.
Oh, they're great, they're
lovely. Are they? Oh, they'll be all right. Well, she will, for a start off. There we are. Yeah, yeah, not that. Now, what we've got to do, you see, every time we point to the audience like that, I want them to shout back nice and loud, if you will, just not much.
Not much.
That's all you've got to shout back. We'll have a practice.
Ready?
And...
Not much!
Oh, very good downstairs, not so good upstairs. One more try. Ready? Not bad. Shall we have a go?
I think that's
right. Righto, right, let's have a go. Say, what do you think of your country today?
Not much!
Not what?
Not much!
Ah. But what do you think of your government, pray?
Not much!
Not what?
Not much!
Ah. But think of your leader, your Margaret T, sticking up petrol by 20p. But tell me, will Michael Foot be better than she?
Not much!
Not what?
Not much!
Still, better than nothing at all.
Not much!
Not better than nothing at all?
Not much!
I'm sure you are with me. Our boy Mike and Maggie are better than nothing at all.
Not much!
Give yourselves a clap. That was good.
Roy Hood, ladies and gentlemen. Roy Hood.
One chick for me.
Three cool chicks. Three cool chicks.
They look like angels from up above. Three cool cats really fell in love. Three cool chicks made three fools of. Three cool cats.
Three cool cats.
From up above, three cool cats really fell in love. Three cool chicks, well, they made three fools of these.
Three cool cats. Three cool cats. Three cool cats. Three.
incomparable Miss Rita Moreno.
I grew strong, and I learned how to get along. And so you're back from outer space. I just walk in to find you here with that sad look upon your face. I should have changed that stupid lock. I should have made you leave your key. If I had known for just one moment, you'd be back to bother me. Go on now, go. Walk out the door. Just turn around now, 'cause you're not welcome anymore. Weren't you the one who tried to break me with goodbyes? Did you think I'd crumble? Did you think I'd lay down and die? No, not I will survive. For as long as I know how to love, I know I'll stay alive. I've got all my life to live. I've got all my love to give. And I'll survive. I'll survive. I'll survive. I'm gonna be all right. I'm gonna be okay. I'm gonna be all right. Okay, I'll be just fine. All right, okay, I'll be just fine. All right, okay. Pieces of my broken heart. But then I spent so many nights just feeling sorry for myself. I used to cry, but now I hold my head up high. And you see me, somebody new. I'm not that chained up little person still in love with you. And so you felt like dropping in and just expect me to be free. But now I'm saving all my loving for someone who's loving me. Go on now, go. Walk out the door. Just turn around now, 'cause you're not welcome anymore. Weren't you the one who tried to break me with goodbyes? You think I'd crumble? You think I'd lay down and die? Not I will survive. For as long as I know how to love, I know I'll stay alive. I've got all my life to live. I've got all my love to give. And I'll survive. I'll survive. I'll survive. I'm gonna be okay. I'm gonna be all right. Okay, I'll be just fine. All right. Okay, I will get my all right. Okay, I'll be just fine. And I'll survive.
Comes on, and only I'm left. Before the parade passes by. I'd better get in step while there's still time left. I'm ready to move out in front. Life without life has no meaning, or I'm left with the rest of them, with the best of them. I need to hold my head up high. I need a goal again. I need a drive again. I need to feel my heart coming alive again. Before the bread passes
cheered me up. Well, it's not been my week. Oh, I dropped a terrible clangor with my neighbour. I saw her coming out of the back door with a wide-brimmed hat and a black veil, and I asked her if she'd taken up beekeeping. She said, no, her husband had just died. I said, I'm ever so sorry. Flo, I said, I didn't know. I said, how did it happen? She said, it were awful. She said it were a Sunday, and he'd just gone out into the garden to cut a cabbage for Sunday dinner when he collapsed and went. No warning, he just collapsed and went like that. Collapsed and went. Oh, I said, oh, Flo, I said, you poor thing. I said, what did you do? She said, I had to open a tin of peas. She said, I blush ever so easily, me. The first time I went to a posh dinner, I was worried about knowing which cutlery to use, and a friend advised me to start on the outside of the place setting with the first course and sort of work my way in, but I mucked it up. I mean, ridiculous. Have you ever tried eating oxtail soup with a napkin? Now, that's what I like about my friend Julie. Whatever I say or do doesn't embarrass her. I've told you about Julie before. She's a big girl. Every morning she stands in front of the mirror and says, mirror, mirror made of glass, am I too fat across the shoulders? She has curves in places where I don't even have places. Oh, and I'll tell you something. She won the Miss Budley Salterton contest 3 years running. That's because she was the only one who could get all the letters across her chest. I mean, you've heard of Beau Derrick. She looks a bit like an oil derrick. But she's very good with kids. She's wonderful. Mind you, she's had enough practice. She tried the rhythm method and ended up with 6 kids who are great tap dancers. She's very good with them, though. Oh, makes real sacrifices for her family. usually involving three joss sticks, some incense and a goat. The other day, I was round there when her youngest kept grizzling for some chewing gum. Well, she didn't have any, but he kept on crying, so in the end, she popped an elastic band in his mouth and told him it were a new flavour. Mind you, he's a bit of a handful, that lad, but she's lucky. Oh, she's lucky. She managed to get his name down for the Ronnie Cray wing of a very expensive maximum security nursery. Mm, she's lucky. Lovely girl, even though she had a very tragic upbringing, you know. Mm. Her father died 3 years before she was born. And she's not a very good cook either. Her husband complained about getting too much shepherd's pie, so the other day she gave him a special treat. Roast suckling mince. Followed by this new pudding she's just invented. It's a snake and spearmint flavoured ice cream. She calls it Minty Python. One of her older lads. Now, honestly, I'm not, you know, casting what's-its-names, but, well, he's got the biggest mouth I've ever seen. When he yawns, it looks like Pierhead at the Mersey Tunnel. It doesn't. I said, it's uncanny. You're not related to Mick Jagger, are you? She said, no. She said, the other day I was making a cake and told him he could lick the cream off the food mixer blades and I forgot to unplug it. But her husband doesn't help. He doesn't. Now, frankly, I can't see what she sees in him. He's got all the personality and drive of a broken digital watch. Lately, he's begun to think he's a refrigerator, which is harmless enough. Harmless, only he sleeps with his mouth open and the light keeps her awake all night. And the romance has gone right out of their marriage. Do you know, she got ever so worried about his lack of attention, so I said to her, I said, listen, why don't you get him a bit jealous, you know, by leaving cigar butts around the house and a pair of army boots under the bed and some pipe tobacco down the edge of the settee? Didn't do any good, he just thought his mother-in-law had been visiting. But she got her own back. One evening, when he was down at the pub, she held a fancy dress Tupperware orgy. She did. She stripped down to her corn plasters and G-strings, run fat all over herself and went as an EEC butter mountain. She did. Well, it's nice to see her enjoying herself. I mean, she worked so hard. Do you know, there's a story that just shows what she's like. A woman called her on the phone and asked how she was and she said, oh, terrible. She said, I've got headache, my back and my legs are killing me, the house is an absolute mess and the kids are driving me crazy. The caller said, listen, go and lie down. I'll come right over and cook lunch for you. You just get some rest. She said, by the way, how's your husband, Sam? She said, Sam? My husband's not called Sam. The caller said, oh, I'm ever so sorry. I must have dialed the wrong number. She said, does this mean you're not coming round?
Strangest feeling, with no vivid reason here to find. Yet the thought of losing you keeps hanging round my mind. Far more frequently you're staying out late, with you say no special place to go. And when I ask, will you be coming back soon? You don't know, never know. Well, I am one of many wishes. I hope my premonition misses what I really feel. My eyes won't let me hide, 'cause they always start to cry. 'Cause this time could mean goodbye. Lately I've been staring in the mirror, very slowly picking me apart. Try to tell myself I have no reason with your heart. Just the other night vaguely heard you whisper someone's name. But when I asked you of the thought you're keeping, you just say nothing's changed. Well, I am one of many wishes. I hope my premonition misses what I really fear. My eyes won't let me hide, 'cause they always start to cry. 'Cause this time could mean goodbye, goodbye. Well, I am one of many wishes. I hope my premonition misses what I really feel. My eyes won't let me hide, 'cause they always start to cry. 'Cause this time
thank you.